Having looked around the box, I can't see any holes in the side of it. But on this corner, as you can see, it's been impacted. See all that cardboard that's been wrinkled up? That's out of focus. There you go. The rest of the box appears to be intact. No dents on any of the other corners. Yeah, that's been hit right on that corner. That's been really hit. There you go. Send and track your own parcels at haymans.co.uk. And this is how they treated my parcel. Brand new. I've never even switched it on. Good job, really. If I had, there would have been sparks flying all over the place. Could have been quite dangerous. This is why you should always check your items that you receive in the post and make sure everything's okay before you switch it on. Yeah. I have just noticed this polystyrene is all cracked. See that there? This must have been slung about all over the place. Can I not read? It says on the box quite clearly, fragile. It doesn't say throw it around the van, does it? They're usually very good, you know. It's all smashed inside there, look. I'm not happy, really, the way they tripped my parcel. And the sender, the person who I bought this from off eBay, has bent over backwards to help me. Sounds very, very helpful. You know, just hassle for everybody, unnecessary. This is how they treat your parcels, they don't care. At least that's the impression I've got here. They don't care at all. I expect not everybody in the organisation is like this. It's just certain people who don't care. Right, there's a picture of the little brass thing inside. Let's see if I can. I'm turning the dial. You see that? You can hear it clattering around inside. There you go. So that's just to show you that that's before I've opened it. Okay, there's no dents that I can see. Do you know, I've been after one of these for years, donkey's years. As you can see, it's in fairly good cosmetic shape. It's just that floating around inside. So I'm going to go and get a screwdriver now. And then start taking this apart. Because you emailed me and said that if I felt happy to do that, okay? So we're going to do that next. This is the bit that's dangling around. This is all sprung up here. Right, that's how it is. Try and get a close up of that. See, there's some bad treatment by the courier by the looks of it. It's got fragile written all over it. What more do they want? Block diagram? Sorry, that went out of focus then. Yeah, not very good, is it? How they treat your stuff. I've been after a Variac for 30 years. And I've never been able to find one I could afford until now. But it's not your fault. Right, I think you've seen enough there. Let's turn it over on its side if I can. Get a better angle of that. All right. I don't know if that's going to affect its operation if I put that back, or whether it's going to work okay. No idea. But it's the brushes that's come out. Right, I've taken out the brushes, and as you can see, one's got the carbon pickup on, and the other one's broken off. I can't see anywhere where the broken bit is, but all it's really needs is new brushes. But also, if you notice this bit here, see that? It's bent up. It's not the same as the one on the other side. See that? It needs bending back again to apply the right pressure on top of the brush. I mean, it doesn't have to press it down hard. It's just enough to make contact with the windings. But see, that's all bent up. But that's the only thing I can see. All it really needs is new spring piece and two new brushes. Probably replace both springs on either side. If this is held in with Loctite, I haven't got any Loctite. I don't know if you've used Loctite when you put this together or not. I haven't tried bending that straight. I can have a go at that if you wanted. It's up to you. I'm happy if you was to replace the broken parts. It's an easy fix. And then see if it worked. If it works fine, it should be okay. If it doesn't, then we'll have to send it back and sort out a replacement. But yeah, there you go. So it's quite clearly been impacted quite hard for it to do all that damage to the packing and to do this kind of damage to the inside. So these are very heavy, as you know. Those that you've got Variacs and that, you'll know how heavy these things are. You know, all the copper windings that's on it. Okay, I think that's enough of that. Get a closer view of that, maybe, without going out of focus. Going out of focus there. I don't even know how much to do to get the focus. But that's quite good, isn't it? There you go. And there's the spring thing. You see, it's bent up there. It's not the same as the other one. So that one's nice and straight. And that one's bent up.